Navigation flows are comprised of clusters, cards, and tabs that allow a user to complete planning tasks in dashboards, task lists, forms, rules, approvals, and reports. You can create navigation flows that control how roles or groups interact in the application. Planning comes with a customizable default navigation flow that guides you through the planning process. Cards are icons you see on the homepage, used to navigate to specific functional areas in the application. You can group multiple cards into clusters. Tab pages are displayed when you click on cards. You can create single or multi-tab pages. Multi-tab pages can be vertical or horizontal. Vertical tabs display tabs with icons on the left side of the page. Horizontal tabs, called subtabs, are links on top of a tab page. I'll create a new navigation flow. You can create a copy of the default navigation flow and use that as a starting point. Before modifying a navigation flow, make sure it is set to inactive. Click the name of the new navigation flow to edit it. Each item is designated a type and state of visibility. You can add, reorder, remove, and modify items. I'll add a new cluster. Next, I'll add a card that opens a multi-tabular page. Vertical tabs can contain single or multiple horizontal tabs. I'm adding a multi-tabular page for my first vertical tab. For content type, you can select to display forms, dashboards, infolets, reports, standard reports, custom reports, or account view. I'll add a couple of forms as horizontal tabs. I'll perform similar steps to add a vertical tab with multiple horizontal tabs. Next, I'll add an expenses card with multiple horizontal tabs containing the following forms: expense comparison, expense summary, expenses by category. You can assign a navigation flow to specific user roles or groups to limit what they can access. Note that there are default access permissions assigned to default roles in the application. For example, a user cannot access the overview card in the application cluster by default. You can remove and disable planning processes accessed by the assigned group or role. You can hide objects or completely remove objects from the navigation flow. You can reorder cluster and card positions using these arrows. When finished, save your changes and close the navigation flow. To enable the navigation flow, set it to active. I'll log off and log back on using a Strategic Planner user account. Notice that the data entry and analysis navigation flow is displayed for this user. In Navigator, you can view the name of the actively loaded navigation flow and the other navigation flows you have access to. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.